Now, the Obama administration has not yet responded to new revelations over the use of defecting child soldiers as intelligence assets by the Somali Intelligence Service. An article in the Washington Post suggests that former child soldiers forcibly recruited by Al-Shabab are being detained in Somalia. They then are being compelled to publicly identify members of Al-Shabab, thereby putting them at risk of being later killed by the militants. The U.S. provides substantial assistance to the Somali security and intelligence services. From Washington, Daniel Ryntjes has more.
The Washington Post story reveals details of the detention of defecting child soldiers in Somalia and their use as intelligence assets is still being absorbed here in the U.S. capital. The article says that several U.S. officials say that for years, the CIA has provided substantial funding and training to the Somali intelligence agency NISA. The CIA typically doesn't provide any public comment on its intelligence activities and refused to comment on this story in particular. In addition, the US provides military assistance, which is subject to public accountability. Now, last year, President Obama issued a waiver to Somalia so that it wouldn't be subject to a law designed to prevent the use of child soldiers worldwide. That law gives the US the ability to prosecute on US soil any individuals who have been involved in the use of child soldiers. It also prevents the US from providing military aid to any country engaged in the use of child soldiers. Now, that waiver was granted on national security grounds, given the pressing and obvious need to help Somalia to combat the Al-Shabaab organization. But so far, the administration has not responded to our request for comment on whether it will reconsider that decision to issue the waiver in light of these new revelations. Now, Human Rights Watch says the decision to continue providing such aid sends exactly the wrong message, not only to the Somali army, but to all Somali security forces. They say that they can continue with the use of children without any consequences to the relationship with Washington.